Every year, we tear down a ton of devices, and we usually get small changes and a decent spec bump. But every once in a while, we get something that really piques our interest. These are our most interesting teardown finds of 2019. When the Galaxy Buds were released in March of 2019, we were skeptical of how similar they might be to the AirPods. But right off the bat, we were happy due to the buds being easy to open. All it took was a little squeezing, prying, and unscrewing to take it apart. Unlike most other earbuds, the Galaxy Buds were designed so that the batteries were easy to access. The process of repairing and recycling these buds is easier and safer since the batteries are easy to remove. And button cell batteries are all you need to keep these buds going, so you never have to worry about not being able to find the right battery. They're available at your corner store or online where other household batteries are sold. Then came along the AirPods Pro, a brand new form factor for Apple's AirPods. With the AirPods' history of being completely unrepairable, scoring a disastrous 0 out of 10 on our repairability scale, we were pretty sure that the AirPods Pro would be just as terrible. But to our surprise, we saw improvements, small improvements, but it's better than nothing. The opening procedure proved to be slightly easier. With some squeezing and prying with the picks, the AirPods opened up. But wait, there's more. The battery that was usually in the stem of the AirPod and almost impossible to remove without complete destruction was now an easier to access button cell battery, just like the one we found in the Galaxy Buds. Insane, right? We also spot a zip connector, which means that you can actually separate the two halves safely. While the rest is still hard to separate and remove from the AirPods, this was a step in the right direction, but not big enough of a step to improve their score. They still got 0 out of 10. In October, the highly anticipated Galaxy Fold was released after being delayed from its initial release back in April. The first time we started hearing about the Fold, reviewers had a ton of technical issues. Mysterious bumps in the display, a removable display covering that was not supposed to come off, whoops, and it also had some other random failures. This made Samsung pull the device before it was even released to the public. Well, October came around and the Galaxy Fold was back, this time with a giant warning label of things not to do. For instance, it says not to press too hard with your fingernail. Some other changes we noticed were that Samsung added a small protective bezel to counter the large gaps at the center of the device, and the hinges on the frame that were once bare are now covered with tape to prevent dirt and grime from getting under the display. Samsung also reinforced the display with an extra metal layer and even extended the advanced polymer protective layer to the edges of the display, making it less of a temptation for people to pull off. These fixes might have improved the durability of the Fold, but it still only scored a 2 out of 10 on our repairability scale. Later on in the teardown season, Microsoft released a device that we had no idea was going to impress us, the Surface Laptop 3. With its history of requiring complete destruction to disassemble, we went into this teardown with our scalpels ready, but by golly, were we really wrong this time. The opening procedure was now completely non-destructive. Removing some screws and lifting up the upper case gives us full access to the laptop's innards. Before, this process would destroy the outer layer, so kudos to Microsoft on this one. Also, this machine definitely surprised us when we realized we could easily upgrade and replace the SSD. The SSD is in plain sight and just one screw gets in the way of removal. Many other parts are also modular, so we're happy that Microsoft took a step in the right direction. Just goes to show that a machine can go from 0 out of 10 to a decent 5 without compromising form factor. And lastly, much to the distress of many of our viewers, we found that the new $6,000 Mac Pro does in fact grate cheese, just not very well. It also became Apple's highest scoring device for as long as we can remember, getting a 9 out of 10. We've already heard some rumblings about the devices that are headed our way, and we know we're gonna have some interesting teardown finds in 2020. So if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel so you can be the first to see what we find next. Happy fixing!